Hi, everyone. Today we're going to be talking about some of the support ticket options that you have. First, you want to go to the JCISD service desk page. And to get there, you just need to type in service.jcisd.org. Now, when you get there, you're going to want to click on the request tab. And you'll notice a section called request type. And next to it, there is a drop down. Now, when you click it, you have a couple options. And before we move on, I want to make clear that East Jackson is the school district that we are using as an example. But when you log in as under your account, it's going to show your school district here. Now, when you click on your school district, you're going to notice that another dropdown will appear, and within it, you have some other options. So the first one is application. Application is for things like software installation, updates, problems you experience with district software. And some examples might include students not showing up in certain products as expected, a student is showing in the wrong class, encountering an error message within a program, an application not working or unavailable. And some example applications that you might experience problems within are things like Renaissance Place, Lexia, Big Ideas Math, Mobi Max, Think Central, Destiny, Illuminate, among others. Now, you'll also notice when you click on application that this green box appears, and that will give you further instructions for when you put in your request details. So this one says, please include the name of the application that you are experiencing issues with. This will help us route the ticket to the correct technician and more efficiently solve your problem. If this is a PowerSchool or Gradebook issue, please select PowerSchool under request type. And that's, you would have to go back to the original dropdown for PowerSchool. Now you'll also notice at the bottom, it says select asset. So we need to know which device is currently not working or having these problems. So all you'd have to do is go in and click on this dropdown and there are some options. And then once you click on whatever device it is, it will also ask you this model piece down here in that dropdown. Now, moving on, after application, you'll notice hardware. The hardware button is for computers, laptops, monitors, projectors, any of those that you're having problems with. Next is network. The network is for things like internet and Wi-Fi problems. Projects is the next one. Now, projects is probably one that you won't use because it is mostly used by the JCISD tech staff internally. So again, you probably won't pick that one. Purchasing is for anything that you need to buy for your district that needs a ticket put in for it. Then we have security. And that's for things like badges, door access, stuff like that. And you'll also notice there's another drop down, and this has a couple options like access control slash doors and cameras that you can pick from. After security, there's user account. This is for things like new staff accounts or new student accounts. And then it also has some more instructions that you can read through in this green box for when you're putting in those request details. Now, if we go back to the original dropdown, you'll notice that after your school district will come PowerSchool. Now, PowerSchool is for things like grades and attendance and stuff like that. But you'll also notice on the right side, there's some frequently asked questions that you can look through and hopefully solve your problem before even having to put in a ticket. After PowerSchool is telephone, so any problems with telephone or connections with that. TyNet, which is now known as PowerSchool Special Education. When you click that, you'll notice that there is another dropdown that will appear, and you can pick any of these options for TyNet to help, you know, make more clear what your ticket is about. Now, after TyNet, we have web page block. And within web page block, this is for anything, you know, if you're having a web page that you're trying to have your students go to or you're going to, and you need to be unblocked. And within it, there's another green box. And this one's really important. It says, when reporting a blocked web page, you can expedite a resolution to your issue by including a screenshot of the block image. And then right here, there you can click for more instructions on how to take a screenshot with the device that you're currently using. And then all you would have to do is come down here and add it as a file. Now, adding a screenshot to any ticket is a great idea because it will give the people who are trying to solve the problem a better idea of what is going wrong because it's a visual.